Hey folks, it's Chris Gonzo Gondek here again for another newsworthy minute from NetApp. Today we've actually got one of our longest standing partners, a NetApp partner in Australia, New Zealand, Flex Data. And Flex Data have come to talk to us today about automation and orchestration using one of the industry's well-known solutions, Ansible. So I'd like to introduce you to Jacob and Luke from Flex Data. Jacob is a senior technical engineer and Luke is the CTO at Flex Data. Welcome, gents.
Hey, Gonzo.
Fantastic. So, Jake and Luke, can you tell us a little bit about yourselves and your roles at Flex Data? And Luke, I'll start with you real quick.
Yes, I'm the CTO and joint owner of Flex Data. We've been running for about 10 years now, and we've been a NetApp partner since inception. So we started just as we were being told to learn clustered ONTAP. And we've rocked and rolled with NetApp ever since. They remain one of our primary partners and the key technology provider for the solutions we provide out to our end users.
Fantastic. Thanks, Luke. And Jacob?
Yeah, Jacob Williams. I'm a senior technical engineer with FlexData. I joined them about 4 years ago now. I've been playing with NetApp from the 7-node 8.0.1 days. So probably going on about 8 or 9 years as well, I think.
Fantastic. So, gents, I've been working with you for a couple of years now, and we've had some conversations around some of the various NetApp technologies like ActiveIQ. And you know, we saw recently that with ActiveIQ, we're starting to find ways to automate and orchestrate solutions to issues that have arisen with across different NetApp product families and systems by using Ansible. So when I first heard that you both were working quite extensively with Ansible to automate and orchestrate a number of things, not just around NetApp, I thought it's a great newsworthy conversation to have. So Jacob, I'll start with you. When did you first start dabbling in automation and orchestration, and what made you look into, you know, technologies such as Ansible?
I started about 7 years ago, initially with different tools, primarily Puppet, but I moved over towards Ansible once discovering that because I preferred its agent-free nature and the vast number of modules and stuff that are available for various different technologies.
Okay. And what's been your experience then so far with using Ansible for the NetApp portfolio specifically? I'm guessing, you know, Ansible itself, automation orchestration tool, agentless, needs to have some sort of APIs to call or commands to call, right, for the NetApp product family. What's been your experience there?
Yeah, no, the experience has been really good there. There's a high level of coverage for the functionality that you have from the ONTAP CLI or from System Manager. So there's not much that I can't do via Ansible that I would normally have gone to the more traditional tools to do.
Fantastic. And what do the Ansible playbooks kind of help you do or do better with your, you know, day-to-day workings as Flex Data with NetApp technologies and in other scenarios?
I think the key there is they help me to be consistent. You know, we deal with multiple different customers with varying different environments and different requirements and different standards. And they give us the ability to codify those standards for each customer in playbooks that are unique for them and gives us the ability to be more consistent with what we deliver to the customers. And it speeds up the time to delivery.
Gotcha. And I guess for other folks who are out there, looking to do things around Ansible and you know, to add to that automation orchestration, where do you kind of keep your Ansible playbooks that you work on and then you test and try and, maintain and update?
I'm keeping them, maintaining them in a private Git repository that's shared amongst the various engineers at Flex Data.
Awesome. And can you give us a kind of an example of the range of capability? I think one of the conversations we had was, you know, you could go from deploying a single volume to, I suppose, what's the scale? You could go to hundreds of systems, right, if you wanted to.
Yeah, absolutely. I've deployed a single volume. I've deployed multiple vServers across multiple clusters with SnapMirror replication configured between all of the volumes that have been set up and all of that through the one playbook that I've put together. I've designed it so that we pass it a parameter file with the different bits and pieces that we need to deploy, be it volumes, vServers, replication relationships, and it will pull in the tasks that it needs to pull in to achieve those things based on the variables that are defined in the file.
That's fantastic. So really helps with kind of any size project, right? From a small deployment to large scale. Fantastic. All right, look, I'll switch gears now and I'll pick on Luke for a second. Luke, you know, with your partnership with NetApp and around the surrounding NetApp technologies, you know, across various on-premises and public cloud environments, and now leveraging automation and orchestration tools such as Ansible, what kind of business benefits, I guess, has FlexData seen from adopting automation and your, you know, NetApp technology portfolio alignment?
Well, there's a number of benefits. They largely stem from, I guess, broadly what we would call efficiency. Mm-hmm. So around being able to deploy in a consistent manner, but also deploy in an automated manner, means we can be a lot more efficient in a number of factors. So we do traditional, you know, solution-led deployment where we might deploy a system, train the end users on its operation and hand it over. So our ability to deploy that system quickly and efficiently is a benefit in our ability to deliver a project profitably, but also competitively against other partners out there that may be bidding for the same business. We also do a lot of managed service where we are jointly or in some cases wholly operationally responsible for our clients' storage and backup and data protection systems. And that efficiencies and the consistencies allow us to be confident that everything is running and humming in the way that we want and the way that we expect it to. And when remediations are happening, they're largely being self-driven automation. So all of those efficiencies provide a competitive advantage and an efficiency and advantage to allow us to deliver at scale for, you know, market competitive rates.
So that, yeah, especially around delivering at scale. So would you say that it removes a certain element of risk as well when you're kind of automating and orchestrating? Is there any kind of human error factors there as well?
Well, absolutely, it removes that risk. So if you can think of large scale environments, might have thousands of volumes. Mm. And, you know, NetApp ONTAP is extremely tunable with all its settings and for a whole lot of different capabilities. Across those 1,000 volumes, we might want to make sure that we're consistent across multiple fields and parameters that can be set, and we can use Ansible to take the heavy lifting away. And also to be regularly checking and ensuring that someone hasn't come in and changed something at some point in time, because Ansible will also be looking through and going, well, essentially, is this compliant with the settings that we expect there to be?
And so there's a bit of a configuration management element to it there as well, right?
Absolutely, yeah. And so that could raise an alert. And then we might go, okay, yes, that volume does need to be an exception and we need to tweak, you know, to tweak the logic a little bit. Or it might say, hey, that shouldn't be like that. And potentially, you know, change it automatically when you find that.
That's brilliant. So overall,
all of that adds risk reduction, efficiencies, you know, competitive advantage ultimately. I mean, these playbooks are also things we can hand over as part of our deliverable to our clients as part of our projects too.
There you go. Some extra value in there. And just like George Kurian said at our a digital insight event just recently, that, you know, speed is the new scale. So incorporating Ansible automation and orchestration to an already existing high performance technology portfolio wraps it all up into that messaging even more, doesn't it?
Yeah. And there is no reason why this couldn't be applied into an existing environment, almost as a health check, and saying, well, you tell us what you think your system should be, what settings your volume, certain volumes should or shouldn't have, and we'll be able to come back and tell you where you comply and where you don't.
That's fantastic.
And potentially auto-remediate if you so choose as well.
Yeah, there you go. Auto-remediation too. Well, look, gents, thank you both for your time. I just have one last question. I'll point it at Jacob. Any advice for other aspiring, you know, automators, orchestrators, configuration managers out there who are thinking about doing something like this with a tool like Ansible?
Yeah, absolutely.
Lessons learned.
Just jump on in. I mean, I started off small. You don't have to try and deploy an entire infrastructure on your first go. You can start with something like just simple user management. You know, the organization I was with at the time had gone through some fairly large growth, and I was trying to find a way to make the repetitive mundane tasks that came along with that go away. Automating them out of the way made it a lot easier, and to the point where I incorporated a lot of it into my home life as well. there's a Minecraft server that I run here for the kids, and I manage that via Ansible.
Updates, yeah, there's some real mission critical systems right there. If the Minecraft server goes offline for the kids, you're going to hear about it, right?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Fantastic. Well, gentlemen, I thank you both so much for your time. It's always really nice when our partners come out to talk to us about our technologies and other surrounding technologies to hear about you know, how you're doing things for our combined customers. So Luke and Jacob from FlexData, thank you so much for coming out and chatting with us on Ansible in this NetApp Newsworthy Minute.
Always a pleasure.
Cheers.
Thanks, mate.
Thanks again.